In last video, we looked at the problem statement. In this video, we are going to talk about aims, grid, and project planning. So after Bhavin Patel, who is a sales director of atliQ Hardware, realizes his pain and he decides to embark on a data analyst project journey, he would call different people from the organization, such as IT team, data analysis team, sales team, and he would brainstorm in a meeting room using aims grid. Now aims grid has four components. The first component is the purpose. What is the purpose of this project? Why are we doing this? And what do we want to achieve using this project? So they clearly define the purpose in the purpose section of aims grid. The second component is the stakeholders. So who all is involved in this project? So in our case, that would be sales team, IT team, and data analysis team. Sometimes people have a data analysis team in-house, and sometimes they outsource the work to some service-based companies. In our case, we are going to assume the team is in-house. Third component is the end result. What do you want to achieve after as a result of this project? So in our case, it will be functioning working Tableau dashboard, which can generate insights for you. Fourth component is the success criteria. Companies spend so much money on doing these projects, but at the end of it, you need to have some measures which can measure the success of that project. So here it could be, okay, after we have this dashboard, we'll make some business decision that will help us save cost by 10%, let's say. Or today sales analysts are spending so much time in merging Excel files which are coming from different regions, and we want to save 20% of that manual time. Or a simple metric could be, okay, 10% increase in sales. So whatever that is, you will record those into success criteria section. After this team has finished brainstorming in their meeting room, and once they have defined this four component of the aims grid, they will initiate the project. You know, they will begin the project. Now for aims grid, I have this link of nice YouTube video. It's in a video description below. You should watch it. There is more detail about aims grid in that video. And if you're targeting a career as a data analyst, technical skills are not the only thing which is important. Your soft skills are very important. So if you know about aims grid and if you can answer questions during the interview, that puts a positive impression on the interviewer. So it's important that you know about it. Now, once these components are defined, these teams will start brainstorming on the next step. So here, I'm going to use some fancy names for these different teams. The first team that is involved is IT team. So IT team, I'm calling it Falcons. So the IT team is responsible for building and maintaining the software that is used by atliQ Hardware. When this company is selling hardware peripheral to different clients, you know, they enter the numbers, the amount, customer name in this software. We call it sales management system, and they print invoice. You know, they do all of that activity in this software, and that software is designed by in-house atliQ Hardware team called Falcons. And behind this software, there is MySQL database. So this database has information on all the transactions. You know, how many peripherals were sold and who is the customer, the date and time of particular transaction. It has all the information. Now the data analyst team, I'm calling it data masters. So data master can directly hook Tableau with the MySQL database, and they can do their analysis and build the dashboard. So that will be the simple approach. And in this project, just to keep things simple, we will follow this approach. In actual life, projects are much bigger. You know, in the big corporation, they have one more component called data warehouse. So what they do is they build this data warehouse where they take the MySQL data and they perform a process called ETL, extract, transform, load. And they store, it's kind of like a copy and transformation, you know, same data, but you transform in a different format. You store in a data warehouse. Now, data warehouse could be Teradata, Amazon, Redshift, or it could be SQL, MySQL. And the people or the team who is responsible for this are called data engineers. In our case, we'll call them data miners. Okay, so miner is a team name, but actually the role, the job role is data engineer. And these people are experts in maintaining the data infrastructure. Now you'd ask me, why do we need to do this extra work? So the MySQL database that we have and the sales management system that we have is called OLTP, Online Transaction Processing System. It's a critical system where the day-to-day sales are being recorded. You know, salesmen are going out and they are recording this business. Maybe they have a laptop. They are actually printing invoice and all that. So now that's a mission critical system. You know, if the system goes down, it will affect your business in a negative way. And data analysis process is very compute intensive. Let's say if data analysts are running queries on MySQL database directly, and if the database gets slower, then you know it will affect your business. So people don't want that. So the companies, what they do is they will create this extra copy of database called data warehouse, where they will transform the data in a way so that it can be analyzed easier. And then data analyst or data scientist will perform their data analysis on data warehouse, not the MySQL database. So data warehouse is called OLAP, Online Analytical Processing System. And if the data warehouse goes down, it's okay. You know, your data analysis process is affected, but your main business day-to-day, your bread and butter is not impacted. So data analyst will hook up to this data warehouse, and then they will either write visualization dashboard, they will have programs, Python programs, pandas programs, you know, different tools for doing data analysis. So this is the structure for a typical data analysis project. But as I mentioned before, we'll keep things simple. We'll directly hook up to MySQL and build a nice dashboard in Tableau. So that's all I had for this video. We looked at aims grid, we looked at different stakeholders which are involved, and the next step. So in the next video, we will look at our MySQL database, and then we'll go through various tables and we'll perform simple data analysis using SQL queries.